discussion on different types of classification of supraventricular tachycardias. Supraventricular tachycardias are those which require the atrium or the AV node for maintenance. In general, they have a narrow QRS, but there can be wide QRS if there is rate-dependent aberrancy or a pre-existing bundle branch block. Another reason for a wide QRS is involvement of an accessory pathway in the antrograde limb of the circuit. SVTs are twice as common in women compared to men. The incidence increases with age. While atrioventricular nodal reentrant tachycardias are more common in adults, atrioventricular reentrant tachycardias due to accessory pathways like Wolff-Parkinson-White syndrome are commoner in children. SVT can be classified into atrial and atrioventricular depending on the region of reentry. It can also be divided into regular or irregular, with atrial fibrillation being the commonest form of irregular tachycardia with a supraventricular origin. The QRS complexes can be narrow or wide as discussed above. SVTs can also be divided into AV node dependent versus AV node independent. Another form of classification of SVT is into short RP, long PR versus long RP, short PR interval tachycardias. Tachycardias with atrial circuit are sinus tachycardia, sinus node reentrant tachycardia, atrial tachycardia, multifocal atrial tachycardia, atrial flutter, and atrial fibrillation. Different types of atrial flutter are typical counterclockwise, reverse typical clockwise, left atrial atypical, and scar-related atrial flutter. Upper loop reentry, lower loop reentry, and figure of eight reentry are other descriptions of the circuits in atrial flutter. Tachycardias with atrioventricular circuits are atrioventricular nodal reentrant tachycardia, AVNRT, AV reentrant tachycardia, AVRT, and junctional ectopic tachycardia, JET. AVNRTs themselves can be three types: typical, atypical, and the slow-slow variety. In the typical variety, antrograde conduction is over the slow pathway and retrograde conduction is over the fast pathway. Hence, the initiating premature atrial complex will have a long PR interval. The RP interval is short, short RP tachycardia in this variety, with PR more than RP interval. P wave is either within the QRS or at the terminal portion of the QRS. These P waves manifest as pseudo S waves in inferior leads and pseudo R waves in V1. Short RP tachycardia with pseudo S in inferior leads and pseudo R in V1. In atypical AVNRT, the opposite pattern of activation is seen, so that RP is more than the PR interval, long RP tachycardia. In the rare slow-slow pathway tachycardia, the reentry occurs between two slow pathways. AVRTs can be divided into orthodromic and antidromic. In orthodromic AVRT, the antrograde conduction is through the AV node and the QRS complex is narrow. Orthodromic AVRTs contribute about 90% of the AVRTs. Antidromic AVRT has the reverse pattern and the QRS is wide and bizarre. JET is due to enhanced automaticity of the AV node and can manifest AV dissociation in the ECG with a narrow QRS. It can be congenital as well as acquired. It can occur in the setting of cardiac surgery and response to cooling, that is induction of hypothermia. Please don't forget to subscribe to this channel for future updates and click on the bell icon for all updates. Thank you.